friends, I am Krishna Kumar and today I am going to discuss how to approach anthropology for UPSC 2022. So basically, when we are trying to understand about any discipline like anthropology, so first, for the understanding of how to approach anthropology, we have to understand what is anthropology, right? Second important thing is that we also try to discuss about method or methodology for the study of anthropology in general and specific. In general means when we try to understand how we study anthropology, how we approach to study anthropology, so we require general understanding about the subject and their approach. But we know that anthropology is divided into mainly four major branches. So when we try to approach sociocultural anthropology and biological anthropology, we utilize different method for the understanding of sociocultural anthropology and biological anthropology. So I will discuss how to approach different branch of anthropology in different way. Then we also try to understand how anthropology is different from another discipline, how anthropology is different from another discipline. This is very important because many students who want to take anthropology as their optional paper, so they may be think how anthropology is different from another discipline like history, like political science, like sociology, like economics, like psychology, like Hindi literature, like life science. So we also discuss how anthropology is different from another discipline. We also try to understand how anthropology is interrelated with another discipline, because when any student who want to learn anthropology, who want to select anthropology as their optional paper, so they may be think that how anthropology is interrelated with history, how anthropology is interrelated with sociology, how anthropology is interrelated with economics, how anthropology is interrelated with political science, how anthropology is interrelated with zoology. So I will discuss on that aspect of anthropology also. And then I will also discuss about why anthropology. Means why should we take anthropology as an optional paper? And then I will also discuss how to study anthropology for UPSC exam, right? Because when we are going to study anthropology for UPSC exam, and when we are going to study anthropology for academic exam, we have utilized different approach for UPSC exam and different approach for academic exam. So I will also discuss on that aspect of anthropology, and After that, we will also discuss some important aspect related to our syllabus and how to approach our syllabus. Basically, this is an introduction class for anthropology, and you can understand how to prepare anthropology for UPSC exam. So first, we try to understand what is anthropology in very simple manner. I am not going to teach anthropology today. Basically, I am going to explain how to understand anthropology in very simple manner for UPSC exam, by which you can select anthropology or not, right? So this is introductory class for anthropology. So basically, when you are going to study anthropology, simply you can understand anthropology is the holistic study of mankind. Holistic study of mankind. This is very simple and accurate definition of anthropology. Simply you can understand it is a holistic study of mankind. So what actually it means? So here is man, and human has many aspect, like it has social aspect, it has political aspect, it has economic aspect, it has psychological aspect, it has religious aspect, it has ecological aspect, it has genetical aspect, it has evolutionary aspect, it has nutritional aspect, it has sports, it has music, it has dance, it has tradition, it has historical aspect. So here, when you are talking about anthropology is the holistic study of mankind, it means we will study total aspect of mankind cross-culturally, right? We will study total aspect of mankind. How it is possible? Because there are many disciplines which focus to study about particular aspect of mankind, but anthropology is the holistic study of mankind. So how it is possible? This is simple question arises in your mind, because anthropology deals with the study of this all aspect of mankind, right? When you try to look out about our syllabus, you found that in anthropology, we study human biological evolution and human biological variation. So topic related to human biological evolution found in UPSC syllabus, topic number 1.4, 1.5, 1.6. And topic related to human biological variation mentioned in our syllabus in topic number 9.1, 9 to 12. But try to observe, when you try to observe about syllabus related to biological anthropology, you found that when we try to study about human evolution, we study human evolution in biocultural perspective. So the role of culture is also important for the understanding of human biological evolution. When we try to study about human biological variation, in which we study human genetics and population genetics, we also study about ecological anthropology, we also study about epidemiological anthropology, We study human growth and development. We study racial classification of mankind. So when we try to study about human biological variation, we also follow biocultural approach. So for the understanding of total aspect of mankind, we need to understand methods or approaches which followed by anthropologist for the study of anthropology. So basically, we study total aspect of mankind in holistic perspective, in cross-cultural perspective, because anthropology deals with the all aspect of mankind. So we follow some methods for the understanding of all aspect of mankind in very simple manner. So in method, here I have divided that method into two kinds: general approach for the study of anthropology. General approach means that approach apply for the understanding of all branches of anthropology. So in anthropology, when we are going to study anthropology, we follow holistic approach. Holistic approach, always try to understand holism, means total aspect, and also try to understand that total aspect interrelated with each other. Means when you try to study about socio-cultural diversity of mankind, we also give attention about biological diversity of mankind, because biological diversity and socio-cultural diversity are interrelated, integrated, interdependent with each other. Without understanding of their integration, we can't understand socio-cultural diversity of mankind or biological diversity of mankind. So here we utilize holistic approach. Another important approach is biocultural approach. UPSC has asked question on that biocultural approach in 2021. So what is biocultural approach? Because man is a biocultural animal, and only man is a biocultural animal in animal kingdom. So our biological and cultural aspect are deeply interrelated with each other. How we can understand that thing? When we are going to study human evolution, so we study human evolution in biocultural factor. So what biological factors are responsible for human evolution, and what cultural factors are responsible for human evolution, how both are integrated with each other, how both are influenced to each other, and human evolution is the product of integration, interrelation of that biocultural factor. Means when we try to understand human evolution, we found that human evolution is primarily a product of organic evolution, which influenced by mutation, gene recombination, hybridization, isolation, migration, genetic dip, and natural selection. These are the important, these are the basic factors which are responsible for organic evolution. Because human is primarily biological animal, so that factors also influence to the process of human evolution, and due to that factor there was development of some specific feature in our ancestor that was large and developed brain proportional to body size in animal kingdom. Second, bipedalism. Third, communication through language. Fourth, grasping capacity in hand. And fifth, stereoscopic vision. So due to this biological feature, there was development of capacity to make culture in human ancestor. So our ancestor started making culture. They started making tools. They started using tools for their livelihood. There was invention of fire. And when our ancestor started utilization of fire in hunting, in cooking, and warming their body, there was development of social rule and regulation for selection of meat. So these types of culture factors influence to biological factor, and therefore human evolution is a product of biocultural factor. So here you can understand that thing. Another important thing is that when we try to study about epidemiological anthropology, or we try to understand about a spread of epidemic disease in population, so we also try to understand that thing in biocultural perspective, because try to understand when anthropologists have been studied about the spread of COVID in different country, in different population, they found that a spread of COVID influenced by biocultural factors of particular population. Therefore, we follow biocultural approach for the study of anthropology. Third important thing is that anthropological study is based on mainly fieldwork method. So in fieldwork method, we utilize participant observation. We follow approach of culture relativism. We utilize approach of microscopic study. We utilize historical method. We utilize comparative method. We utilize emic and ethic approach for the understanding of anthropology. So these are the basic thing when you are going to study anthropology. Give attention about that general methodology and approach for the study of anthropology, right? Then here you can also understand some specific approach for the understanding of anthropology, because I already said that anthropology is divided into mainly four kind. So when we are trying to understand about sociocultural anthropology, right? So that general approach apply for the understanding of sociocultural anthropology. But sociocultural anthropology develop a specific approach for the study of their subject matter. So basically in sociocultural approach, at first we utilize ethnography and ethnology. So try to understand that two important thing, ethnography and ethnology. That ethnography method was based on primary data, and that primary data collected by participant observation, and ethnology was based on secondary data. So in anthropology, when we try to study anthropology, basically sociocultural anthropology, their study is mainly based on participant observation or fieldwork method. But recently there are development of many modern method, modern tools and technique for the study of sociocultural aspect of mankind. So when you try to study sociocultural anthropology, we have to understand about new ethnography, right? And you have also tried to understand about post-modernism or post-modernism approach for the understanding of sociocultural anthropology. So try to understand, recently we give focus about case study, right? Case study method, tools is applied for the study of sociocultural aspect of mankind. So basically when we are going to study anthropology for UPSC exam, try to collect proper case study. One thing I feel that there are many students who confused regarding case study. They are using some news material as a case study. That is not a case study. Case study means anthropologists have done that study by using case study method, and data gathered by anthropologist on the basis of case study, that is case study. So whenever you try to utilize case study in your examination, try to understand that is case study, that is not a current event. If you try to use current event, then you have to write example, not term case study. So in sociocultural anthropology, we utilize that specific method, that specific methodology, that specific approach. Approach is also very important when we are going to study sociocultural anthropology, because when you try to study about anthropological theory, right? This topic is very important for the understanding of sociocultural anthropology. So when you try to understand about development of anthropological theory from classical evolutionism to diffusionism to historical particularism to functionalism, structural functionalism, structuralism, neo-evolutionism, culture and personality school, interpretive anthropology, cognitive anthropology, cultural materialism, and postmodernism. Basically, these are the important theories which mention in our syllabus. But that theories give us some important insight for the understanding of human culture, for the understanding of human behavior, for the application of that approach for the understanding of our syllabus also. So try to make correlation between aspect of sociocultural anthropology like marriage, family, kinship, economic anthropology, political anthropology, religion, and anthropological theory. Try to correlate. And if you have very good knowledge regarding anthropological theory and you apply particular types of approach for the understanding of particular types of social intuition, then you can better understand and then you can get very good marks in anthropology. So when we study sociocultural anthropology, we apply different approach than biological anthropology, because when we try to understand about biological anthropology, so approach which utilize for the study of biological anthropology that is quite different from sociocultural anthropology. In biological anthropology, we study major two aspects of mankind. First is human evolution. Try to understand that thing. First is human evolution, and second is human biological variation. Right? First is human evolution, and second is human biological variation. So when we are going to study human evolution, so for the understanding of human evolution, we apply fieldwork method. First, fieldwork method. And second, laboratory method. Try to understand this thing. in very simple manner. But I already said that in sociocultural anthropology we also utilize fieldwork method. So how fieldwork method apply in biological anthropology is different from sociocultural anthropology. So basically in biological anthropology we utilize fieldwork method in primatology, and paleoanthropology. Right? Primatology and paleoanthropology. So, when primatology try to understand about social behavior of non-human primate, they are doing fieldwork with non-human primate like prosimian, monkey and ape. They are doing observation about the behavior of that non-human primate. So their fieldwork is not a kind of participant observation, but they are observing about the behavior of that non-human primate. So here they also use fieldwork method. They trying to observe about the natural behavior of non-human primate in their natural setting. Second, when paleoanthropologists try to understand about human evolution on the basis of fossils remains. So for the understanding of human evolution, first they are doing discovery of fossils remains, right? So that happened on the basis of fieldwork method. So here they also use fieldwork method, but that fieldwork is quite different from sociocultural anthropology. Try to understand, it may be possible UPSC asks question fieldwork method in biological anthropology. So fieldwork method also apply in biological anthropology, but that fieldwork method is quite different from fieldwork method apply in sociocultural anthropology. In paleoanthropology, at first anthropologists try to discover fossils remains. So they are searching fossils remains by application of fieldwork method. Then they are excavating that paleoanthropological site. So here we also utilize fieldwork method that is quite different from sociocultural anthropology. But in anthropology, there are development of DNA dating method for the dating of fossils remains. We utilize mid-DNA for the understanding of human evolution, for the understanding of migration of human ancestor from one place to another place. So here we utilize DNA data. That DNA data analyzed on the basis of laboratory method. So try to understand in biological anthropology, even when we try to study about human biological evolution, we also utilize fieldwork method and laboratory method. When we try to study about human biological variation, right? So for the human biological variation, we also utilize fieldwork method. Earlier, anthropologists study human biological variation on the basis of study of racial variation. So they utilize anthropometric measurement method for the understanding of racial differences in human society, physical differences in human society. We still utilize that method. When we try to study about ecological differences in human society, Differences due to environmental factor in human society, differences in their physical feature and differences in their socio-cultural feature, we utilize fieldwork method. We also utilize fieldwork method for the understanding of human growth and development, for the understanding of nutritional problem, for the understanding of the spread of epidemic disease in population. But in biological anthropology, especially in human genetics, we utilize mainly laboratory method. So here we also utilize fieldwork method, but we mainly depend on laboratory method. So the nature of biological anthropology is very, very objective. Objectivity present in biological anthropology, and therefore we get very good marks in biological anthropology as well as another branches of anthropology. So my focus is that here, my focus is that when you are going to study anthropology, try to understand how we study anthropology. So we have to give focus for the understanding of method utilized for the study of anthropology. Third important thing is that when we study about archaeological anthropology, so in archaeological anthropology, we also utilize some specific method, archaeological anthropology. So here we also utilize fieldwork method. Right, but that fieldwork method is quite different from method applied in sociocultural anthropology, because in archaeological anthropology, archaeologists have done two important work. First, archaeological exploration, and second, archaeological excavation. So for archaeological exploration, they are using fieldwork method. They are moving one place to another place for the searching of archaeological site. Recently, we utilized some advanced method for the searching of archaeological site, for the discovery of archaeological site. But after discovery of archaeological site, they are doing archaeological excavation, and they are mainly using vertical and horizontal method. So that vertical and horizontal method is an important kind of fieldwork method. So try to understand, when we study archaeological anthropology, we also utilize fieldwork method. So once time UPSC has asked question, fieldwork in archaeological anthropology, fieldwork method in archaeological anthropology, many students became confused because they have not gave attention about that, what method we utilize for the study of particular branches of anthropology. In such way, in linguistic anthropology, because linguistic anthropology is very closely related with socio-cultural anthropology, so here for the understanding of linguistic and culture diversity, interrelationship between culture and language, anthropologists mainly utilize fieldwork method and participant observation. So through that discussion, you can capable to understand how anthropology is very unique discipline, how we understand anthropology, how we utilize different method for the understanding of anthropology. Then we try to discuss about how anthropology is different from another discipline. So first important thing you remember always, anthropology is holistic science. Means when we study anthropology, we study human biological evolution and human cultural evolution. So no any discipline which focus to study about both human biological evolution and cultural evolution. When you study about history, that mainly focus to study about human cultural evolution and cultural development. And when you study about life science, that mainly focus to study about human biological evolution, not on human cultural evolution. So first thing, remember that anthropology study total aspect of mankind cross culturally. Another discipline mainly focus to study about particular aspect of mankind, like history mainly focus to study about cultural evolution and cultural development. Sociology mainly focus to study about social aspect of mankind. Economics mainly focus to study about economic aspect of mankind. Political science mainly focus to study about political aspect of mankind. Psychology mainly focus to study about behavioral aspect of mankind. Philosophy mainly focus about philosophical aspect of mankind. Literature mainly focus to literary aspect of mankind. But when we try to study about anthropology, we study all these aspect of mankind. So basically in anthropology, we study this different aspect of mankind in very simple manner, very simple way, in introductory way. And therefore, when you try to observe about your syllabus, you found that there are different chapter present in our syllabus which are related with another discipline. Like when we try to study about human evolution or human biological variation, that topic is closely related with life science. But in anthropology, we follow biocultural approach, but life science follow atomistic approach for the study of these aspect of mankind. When you try to compare about sociology, so sociology also interested to study about human social aspect like marriage, family, kinship. But sociologists follow macroscopic approach, social survey approach for the study of these aspect of mankind. Anthropologists, basically social anthropologists, follow microscopic approach, follow holistic approach, follow participant observation, follow cultural relativism for the understanding of these aspect of mankind. Only one topic related to economic anthropology, that is very closely related with economics, but we study economic anthropology in only one topic. So we study that aspect of mankind in very simple way, very introductory way, and therefore it is possible to study each and every aspect of mankind in one discipline like anthropology, right? So through that discussion, you can capable to understand how anthropology is different from another discipline and how anthropology is interrelated with other discipline. But lastly, that is very important question for every student: why anthropology? So when we try to analyze about this question, why anthropology, it has two important aspects. First, why should we take anthropology as their optional paper? And second, also you try to understand why students getting very high score in anthropology in every year in UPSC exam. there are two important things. Here, when you try to understand that aspect, why anthropology, for the selection of optional paper, for the selection of optional paper, every student trying to understand the nature of subject matter, try to understand about marks, record previous year's marks, record, and trying to understand about materials. So when you try to understand about why should we take anthropology as the optional paper, first try to observe about syllabus. So when you observe about syllabus, so your syllabus is very short and limited, right? First thing is that this is very important. This is very important criteria for the selection of optional paper in UPSC exam. So first important thing is that when you try to observe about UPSC syllabus related to anthropology, you found that its syllabus is very concise, very limited, very solid, very small. Second important thing is that each and every aspect defined in our syllabus, if you try to correlate, if you try to understand your syllabus on the basis of previous year question, you found that UPSC directly asks question from our syllabus, right? So here it is very small, very short, very concise. Second important thing is that anthropology is very scientific, right? Very scientific discipline. It has objectivity. The role of objectivity is very important because you are trying to select anthropology for UPSC exam or PCS exam, right? So your main goal is how to get high marks in our optional paper. So if there is objectivity present in any discipline, then you can get very high marks. As for example, if you select mathematics, if you select physics, they have high objectivity. But because the nature of mathematics, the nature of physics is very tough, so it is not possible to each and every student who belongs from different discipline to take mathematics as their optional paper. But anthropology is social science and it has objectivity. So a student belongs from technical background or social science background, they can easily take anthropology as their optional paper. Fourth important thing is that the subject matter present in our syllabus, that is easy to understand. There is no confusion regarding any topic which present in our syllabus. So it is easy to understand. It is interesting also. And main thing is that if you try to observe about performance of anthropology from previous year student, you found that most of toppers coming from anthropology. So why topper coming from anthropology? Because the nature of that subject is very objective. We can understand this subject in very simple manner. We have possibility to put diagram, put map in our answer, and therefore we can get very high marks in anthropology. Lastly, presently there is sufficient material present in our country for the study of anthropology, so you can easily take anthropology as their optional paper and try to prepare anthropology in scientific manner, in holistic manner. But if you select anthropology, then you have two options. First important thing is that, is it possible to prepare anthropology by self-study? Yes, it is possible. If you try to study anthropology through self-study, it is possible. But if you try to prepare anthropology in very limited time, so try to select proper mentor. And if you try to select your mentor, so what should be done? So first important thing is that when you try to take coaching for anthropology, so at first you talk your teacher. Your teacher, if your teacher will prepare whole syllabus according to UPSC, then you can join with that teacher. Because once time, if you prepare whole syllabus and if you write answer about previous year's question more than 5 years, then you will be capable to get very high marks in anthropology. So on the basis of that, you can prepare anthropology. I have teaching anthropology since last 15 years, and my approach is that I am discussing all things in class, I dictate all things in class, and I discuss how to write answer in class. I dictate some answer also. Presently, I have started offline class at Old Rajendranagar, Delhi. And I also provide offline class. So those students who wants to join with me in my offline class, they can join with me at Old Rajendranagar. Those who are not at Delhi, they can join with me in my online class. For detail, you can give message to me or you can call to me for more information about anthropology. Thank you.